The next question, posed by Brother Abdul Haq from Tamil Nadu, India. Is Dawah compulsory? Yes. Dawah is a fard. It is compulsory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Al-Asr, chapter number 103, verse number 1 to 3. He says, Wal Asr. Innal insana lafi khusr. That by the token of time, man is verily in a state of loss. Allah is taking the oath of time that man is verily in a state of loss. Except those who have faith, those who do righteous deeds, those who exhort people to truth, and those who exhort people to patience and perseverance. This Surah Al-Asr is the Rahi Nijat. It is the path to Jannah. It is the criteria for any human being to go to Jannah. And Allah says in the surah, Surah Al-Asr, that humankind is in loss, is in khasara, except if you have four things. Number one is iman, belief, faith. Number two is righteous deeds, amal salihat. Number three is watawasaw bil haqq, that is inviting people, exhorting people to truth, that is doing dawah and islah. And number four is watawasaw bil sabr, inviting people to patience and constancy. So for any human being to go to Jannah, minimum four criteria are required. Iman, that is belief, righteous deeds, inviting people to truth, dawah or islah, and inviting people to patience and perseverance. If any one of these four is missing, you may be a very good Muslim, you may be praying five times a day, you may have gone for Hajj, you may be giving zakat, you may be fasting in the month of Ramadan, but if you don't do dawah, if you do not invite people to the haqq, then according to Surah Al-Asr, you shall not enter Jannah. If Allah wants to forgive you and grant to Jannah, that is Allah's prerogative. But if you do not do dawah according to Surah Al-Asr, you shall not enter Jannah. According to Imam Shafi, he said that if this surah alone was revealed, it would have been sufficient for the hidayah, for the guidance of humankind. It's such a powerful surah. And one of the criteria to go to Jannah is dawah. So dawah is compulsory, it's not optional. Some people say it is fard kifaya. No, it's not fard kifaya, it is fard ain. It is compulsory, every Muslim should do dawah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3, ayat number 110, says, Kuntum khaira ummatin ukhrijat lin nas. Say, ye Muslims, ye are the best of people evolved for mankind. Because you enjoin what is good and forbid what is wrong and believe in Allah. Allah is calling you a khaira ummah because the best of people because you enjoin what is good and forbid what is wrong and believe in Allah. If you do not enjoin what is good and if you do not forbid what is wrong, if you do not do dawah, you are not fit to be called as khaira ummah. You are unfit to be called as the best of people. Therefore, doing dawah, inviting non-Muslims to the truth of Islam is compulsory. That's the reason Allah called you as khaira ummah. Allah also says in the glorious Quran, in Surah Fusilat, chapter number 41, verse number 33, وَمَنْ أَحَسُنُ قَالَ مِمَّنْ دَوَيْلَ اللَّهِ, that who is better in speech than one who invites people to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ أَحَسُنُ قَالَ مِمَّنْ دَوَيْلَ اللَّهِ وَأَمِلُ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in speech than one who invites to the way of thy Lord, who works righteousness and says that I'm a Muslim. The best profession, according to the glorious Quran, is a person who invites people to the truth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is a da'i. The best profession for a Muslim is a da'i. What was the beloved Prophet? He was a messenger of Allah. He was a da'i. So dawah is compulsory. And if you read the Quran, one third of the Quran is talking about the non-Muslims, about the Ahl Kitab, about the Jews and Christians. Qul ya al kafirun, qul ya al kafirun. Saying, say to the one who rejects the faith, say to the non-Muslims. Allah says, qul ya al kitab, say O Ahl Kitab, say O Jews and Christians. So all this Allah is telling you to tell them. Allah says, qul, 332 times in the Quran. Tell them, tell who? In a salah, in the masjid, the imam is reciting, Qul huwallahu ahad, say he's Allah one and only. Now everyone in the mosque are Muslims, they believe Allah is one. So who is the Imam telling? Imam is telling us Muslims that when you go out of the mosque, say to those who don't believe in one God that Allah is one. How many of us Muslims do that? The Imam is reciting, Kul ya al kafirun, say to those who reject faith. Everyone in the mosque, they have faith. Allah is telling the Muslims to go and tell those non-Muslims. Tell them. Allah is saying, Kul ya al kitab, say O people of the book, say O Jews and Christians. Allah says, Wala taqulu salasa, do not say Trinity. How many of us Muslims follow the Quran? One third of the Quran is telling you, tell to the non-Muslims, tell to the Ahle Kitab, tell to the unbelievers. How many of us Muslims do Dawah? Dawah is for the end. It is one of the criteria to go to Jannah. If you do not do Dawah under normal circumstances, you shall not go to Jannah. If Allah wants to forgive you, as Allah says, Allah will forgive any sin except the sin of shirk, and Allah wants to put you in Jannah, that's Allah's prerogative. But Dawah is compulsory, is for the end, and every Muslim should do Dawah as much as possible. It is the best profession.